I'm trying to work here. Yeah. Watch your head, you're gonna scratch your head.
Well, that's a whole lot of overkill for a workbench with a table saw incorporated into it. I've never done that type of joinery before. I've seen other YouTube channels and other YouTube videos of these, I believe they're called castle joints, and then all the other type of joinery that I had to put into this workbench to make it come together. This was probably not the best first project for all that joinery. It took a very long time to cut all those pieces, and some of them got a little bit of slop in them, but all in all, it went together really nice. I did put some screws in the ends to help hold everything solid as the glue dried. And I did use my heater, tarp the workbench. That's why I put the heater blowing in the one end, warm this workbench up. I think today the high was 40, which, believe it or not, felt kind of nice. I actually took my coveralls off at some point and enjoyed a little bit of warm weather. Now the sun's kind of going down. We're chilling back up, so coveralls came back on. But it's done, it's solid, I like it. I'll be able to cut a full sheet of plywood as the other workbench I have over here will butt up to that end and it'll be a little bit lower, leaving me a longer runoff table going out that direction. I did think about, the thought had crossed my mind to put the table saw the other direction so it would feed through this way. But most of the woodworking channels that I've come across have the table saw this direction, and I figure they have more experience. They probably have it this direction for a reason. So that's why I put it this direction instead of the long ways. Not a big deal. I can always pull that other bench over, hook it up, and have a longer runout bench going out the side there. Be able to cut a full sheet of plywood by myself, no problem. If you like the video, hit that thumbs up button for me. If you like to see stuff get made and built, hit that subscribe button, little bell for notifications. If you want to support the channel, we have a couple different ways you can support the channel. Number one, simply watch another video. Hit the thumbs up button, leave a comment, helps our channel grow. Two, we have an Amazon affiliate link in the description. Click on that link, do your shopping on Amazon. Doesn't cost you a penny, but it gives us a slim percentage for being the ones to send you there. And the third option, we do have a Patreon account. Become a patron, donate whatever you feel like per video, per month. It's there if you want to use it. No problem if you don't. There is nothing extra on the Patreon channel. I don't put out extra content on the Patreon channel because I want my content to be out there on YouTube to inspire people. I don't want to hold certain content for people that support my channel in that aspect. I don't even care if you support my channel through Patreon. It's there because a few people have asked about it, so we made the Patreon account and they've joined it. No problem if you don't want to do that. I'm not here to ask for money. I'm here to help inspire people, to show people that you can build stuff, you can make stuff. Even if you have never done it before, you can do it. And on that note, until next time, go make something.